Good day, everyone! Welcome back to my channel. Today, we will learn ratio and proportion. So, what's the essential skill? Basic lang po ang dapat andyan na sa inyo. Multiplication of integers only. Okay? So, if you have the mastery of multiplying integers, then this topic will be very easy. So, I start at home. I love to learn mathematics. I love to learn ratio and proportion. I love to pass the examination. Okay? Now let's start. What is ratio? Ratio is a comparison of two numbers by division. Sir, anong ibig sabihin niyan? Comparison of two numbers by division. Okay. So let us have 1/2. Baka magtanong kayo, sir, is 1/2 a ratio? Is in this form? Yes. This form is already a ratio. Pero baka sabihin nyo, sir, di ba fraction din yan, sir? Fraction ito. Ngayon, ratio na siya. Yes. Okay? So, basically, fraction and ratio are the same, basically, in mathematics. But their usage is different. Okay? So, let's talk about their usage. So, when we talk about fraction, no, we discuss or we deal with this numerator and denominator thing as a whole. Okay, like 1/2 sheet of paper. Okay, so 1/2 sheet of paper. So this is the 1/2 sheet of paper. So this is this number, top number and bottom number is treated as a whole, as a fraction. If it's a ratio like this, say 1/2 pa rin as our example, as a ratio, then our top number is different from the bottom number. Say, I can clean one house in 2 days. Para mga ganyan. Okay, so let's example for a fraction, just a review. 1/4. Okay, we treat this as a whole thing. So 1/4 no, sa paper na to, this is the 1/4. Okay, so this is a 1/4. Pero, pag ratio na siya, so may makatumbas na po na representation si top number at saka si bottom number. So let us say, ang makain ko na durian, for example, is 1 durian, whole durian in 4 hours. See? The usage lang po ang difference nila. Okay? Now, let us have representation of ratio. You know, nakikita nyo na ito sa mga books. Itong representation na parang colon. So, ito po ang ibang pag-represent, pag-write ng ratio. So, example number one, the ratio of 2 to 3 is translated or is translates to 2 to 3. Ganyan. Or, like kanina, pwedeng ganito. Diba? When we talk about ratio. How about the ratio of 5 to 12 translates to? So, ganyan lang, 5 to 12. Or, ang ganito na form. Okay? The ratio of 5 to 1. Sige, that's right. At home, pause the video. Basic lang, di ba? 5 to 1. And remember, it's called unit ratio if the denominator or if the bottom number is 1. Okay? If the bottom number is 1, it's a unit ratio. Okay? Okay. So, let's have examples. Baka ganito ang mga questions sa exam. But the questions on ratios are easy lang. Ganito lang po ng mga example. Example, in a class of 45 students, 25 are girls. Find the following. The ratio of girls to boys. So, sa class daw, may 45 ka students. 25 are girls. So, surely, 20 are boys. Diba? Hindi na nilagay kasi parang bag-analyze ka. This is an examination. You should have an analysis. The analysis. Hindi na ibigay na lahat. Okay. So, the ratio of girls to boys. So, may 25 ka girls. Ay, ganito lang. Oh, basic. Yes. Basic lang po ang mga topic na ito. Ratio and proportion. Example number 2. The ratio of boys to students. So, ilang boys? 20. Ilang students? 45. Ganyan lang, sir? Yes! Ganyan na ganyan lang. Diba? CCO lang pala? Very easy. Number 3. The ratio of students to girls. Girls to po. So, girls, ilang students? 45. Ilang girls? 25. And that's it. Ganyan lang po ka-basic ang example ng ratio. So, let's pray that in your examinations po, may kahit isang tanong na ganito para sure ka ng check ka na. Okay? Very basic. Now, let's talk about proportion. Okay? I love to learn proportion. My heart and mind is open to learn proportion now. Let's define proportion. Proportion is a mathematical comparison between two numbers. Oh, it's a comparison between two numbers. But since we are talking with ratios, two ratios are said to be in proportion when two ratios are equal. They're in proportion when they are equal. So, let's have example again. 1 over 2. The representation, say, I can clean one house in 2 days. Ganyan no, ang mga representation. Now, kung dalawang houses ang na-clean ko, at the same pace ang pag-clean ko, the same lang na window for 5 minutes, parang ganyan, ceiling for 20 minutes, the same lang, ilang days kaya? So, possibly, surely, if the same pace, 4 days po akong mag-clean. Diba? Ganyan. And, look at this point. Two ratios, dalawang ratio daw, are said to be in proportion when they are equal. So, the question is 1 half equal to 2 over 4? Is 1 over 2 equal to 2 over 4? Yes na yes. Diba? They are just equivalent fractions. Diba? Kung i-reduce natin ito, this is just 1 half. Pero pag ratio na, again, we have representations sa dalawang numbers, sa top at bottom numbers. And if this is the case, this is in proportion. Ha? When the two ratios are equal, it is said that they are in proportion. Okay? So, cross products of proportion are always equal. So, gamitin natin kanina. Si 1 half at saka si 2 4. Sinasabi na kapag i-cross product natin or cross multiply, kung equal sila, it's in proportion. Ano ang cross multiplication? Cross lang guys. 1 times 4, 4. 2 times 2, 4. Ay, sir, they are equal. Hence, this is a proportion. Diba? Ganyan, a proportion is just a comparison of two numbers. And we talk about, if we talk about ratios, we talk about equal ratios. Ganyan lang pala ang proportion. Yes, ganyan lang po ka-basic. And how to solve proportions? Ito lang po ang steps. Cross-multiplication lang ipasok nyo sa mind. But these are the steps, no? Calculate the cross-products or cross-multiply. Set the cross-products equal to each other, then solve the equation. Baka sabihin nyo, ay, ang taas, sabi ni sir, cross-multiplication lang. Yes, the essence of the three is just cross-multiplication, then solve. Example, here. Probably, let us have solve for x. Probably the question is solve for x, no? Okay, or find x. Now, if this is the case, ano nga yun? Cross products lang. 4 times x, 4x. 3 times 8, may equal sign tayo, no? Equal 24. We are just asked to find x, not 4x. So, paano matanggal si 4? I-divide natin both sides by 4. Bakit ganyan, sir? Kasi 4 divided by 4, o sige, ilagay natin dito sa banda dito, 1. 1, so ang na-remain, 1x equals 6. 1x is just x equals 6. Hence, x is 6. Huh? Are you sure, sir? Okay, let's check kung may mga question tayo sa mind natin, i-check nyo. So, let's check. 3, 4, tapos 6 over 8. Let's cross multiply down. 3 times 8, 24. 4 times 6, 24. Same siya, sir. Therefore, this is in proportion because the two ratios are equal. Wow! Wow na wow! Napaka-basic lang talaga. Okay? So, I introduce this topic first, this cross-multiplication, because in solving word problems, no, involving proportion, ratio and proportion, we will have this way. We will solve using cross-multiplication like this. Okay? Example, a recipe for oatmeal cookies calls for 2 cups of flour for every 3 cups of oatmeal. How much flour is needed for a big batch of cookies that uses 9 cups of oatmeal? Okay, so ang style yan, guys, since this is a ratio and proportion topic, at dapat sa mind yung kapag hindi kasi sa exam no na bigyan ka ng problem, tapos lagyan dito, ratio and proportion. No! Kayo ang mag-identify at kayo ang mag-solve, of course. Di ba? Okay. So, if this is the case, ganito na mga question, guys. Oh, so, if dito na mga question, syempre, ma-analyze nyo, 2 is 2, 3, blank is 2, 9. Ratio and proportion yan, sir. Yes! So, paano isulat? Sige. So, first, ang mag-given natin. Sa 2 cups of flour daw, 2 cups of flour, may katumbas na 3 cups of oatmeal. Diba? Oatmeal. And, information din sa everyone. Information, if nasa top number na natin, we choose it to be cups of flour, then, sa bottom number is cups of oatmeal, sa second ratio na gagawin natin, guys, which is useful para pag-find natin no, sa answer, dapat nasa top din si flour, na sa bottom si oatmeal. Sige daw? Let's continue. How much flour is needed? Oh! Flour ang tinatanong. Therefore, dito tayo maglagay sa top number, which is X. Sir, bakit X? Hindi pa natin alam. We do not know yet. Sir, can we use another variable? Y, Z? Yes, you can. From A to Z, from alpha to omega, what you want. It's okay. But we are used to X. No. Kasi si X nga, huwag na natin pakialaman. Diba? X. Tapos, kasi ang tanong, how much flour is needed kuno para gumawa ng cookies na gagamit ng 9 cups of oatmeal? Hala, ang oatmeal nasa bottom number ko. So, dito dapat siya. 9 cups of oatmeal. I have 2 ratios na. Since I'm going to find for X, ganito ang ipoporma ko. 2 over 3 equals X over 9. Then, if that's the case, like my first example, cross multiplication. 3 times X, 3X, cross multiplication. 2 times 3, 2 times 9, 18. How to remove 3? I-divide po natin sila both sides by 3. Hence, X is 6. Therefore, we need 6 cups of flour. Okay, let's check this, no? Para lang malagay nyo sa puso at mind nyo kung tama ba talagang na-solve natin. So, 2 times 9, 18. 3 times 8, 18. It's really in proportion because the first ratio is just equal to the second ratio. Ganyan! Ganyan na ganyan na ganyan na ganyan lang. I love to learn math. I love to learn ratio and proportion. Ganyan! Let's try example number 2. Ba? Basic. Here, Teresa is maintaining a campfire. She can keep the fire burning for 4 hours with 6 logs. 4 hours daw ang fire. Imagine nyo sa mind nyo, one of the ways to solve this also, word problems, imagining the situation, for 6 logs, mga malaking logs. Sa pagkanang, imagine ko, baka maliit lang sa inyo, okay lang yan. She wants to know how many logs she needs. Uy, may idea ka na. Sa first 2 sentences pa lang, no, may idea ka na, may ratio na dun. She wants to know how many logs she needs To keep the fire burning for 18 hours, she assumes all logs are the same. Okay, so sa first ratio, may malagay na ako nga, 4 hours daw, for 4 hours, 6 logs ang kailangan. Ah, oh, yes, given yan. Tapos, sa second, she wants to know how many logs. Hala, gusto niyang malaman ilang logs ang magamit kong 18 hours. Saan ko nilagay si hours? Tanong niyo sa sarili niyo. Sa top number. Ah, so si hours, guys, dito siya. Sa top number, 18 hours. How about si logs? Do we know how many logs? Hinahanap pa natin, sir. Kaya i-X lang muna natin. Because we do not know yet. Ha? Again, any variable will do. Logs. And, since we have the same in top number, we have the same in bottom numbers, then, we can solve. Let's try. 4 over 6, 18 over X, cross multiplication. Diba? 4 times X. Kung saan si X, ganyan na lang guys, no? Iunan nyo na. Pag-solve kung saan si X. Tapos, 6 times 18. So, kita isolve natin, no? Kung hindi natin kaya sa mata, so, isolve natin. 108. Okay. Now, question is, are we looking for 4X? No, sir. We're just looking for X. Yes. So, we divide this with 4. Hence, X is, so, kung hindi ba natin makaya sa mata, so, isolve natin by this long division. 2, 8, 2, 8. 27. X, sir, is 27. And you check that at home. You try checking at home. Kahit checking lang muna ang isolve nyo. If that's correct, then they are in proportion. Ganyan po. Ganyan po ka-basic. Diba? Mga basic lang po actually ang mga question sa ratio and proportion. Let's have number 3. Here. Mika can eat. Dapat kung mga ganito na question, guys, nasa mind yun na ang pag-form ng two ratios, tapos cross-multiplication, ganyan. Mika can eat 10 hot dogs in 30 minutes. She wants to know how many minutes it would take her to eat 35 hot dogs if she can keep up the same pace. Okay, guys? Sa mga question, usually, guys, no, kung lalo na kung mga kain-kain, mga work, lagyan talaga ng same pace. Or same, anong ibig sabihin ng pace ha sa Tagalog? Daw, like sa house, no? Like sa sinabi kong example sa house, if mag-clean ako for one day in one house for one day, example, for 2 days, so meaning, sa windows, 10 minutes, sa ceiling, 20 minutes, parang maganyan, sa floor, 30 minutes. So the same pace then sa pag-clean ko ng bawat house. So, sa second house naman, 10 minutes sa window, ganyan ang ibig kong sabihin. So, nilalagyan usually ang mga question na to kasi if we don't assume na if we have different pace, so hindi po ito correct na pag-solve natin. So, kasi dapat of the same pace. Okay? If you have question about it, I will dig deeper in a comment box. Okay, so let's form this. 10 hot dogs daw, hot dogs, makain niya in 30 minutes. Diba? Parang ang tagal, no? Kasi 10 hot dogs in 30 minutes. Or parang exact lang, parang tama lang. Then, she wants to know how many minutes. Ay, ang minutes nasa bottom number, so ilagay natin si X sa bottom number. Ganyan, X minutes. Tapos, 35 hot dogs nasa top number, 35. Tapos, cross-multiply. Ay, ka-basic lang pala, sir. Yes! Basic na basic na basic lang. Wow na wow, I will be topping the licensure examination for teachers. 10 and the CSE exam. 10 times X, 10X. 30 times 35, let's solve here. 30 times 35, 0, 15, carry 1, 1,050. I also have discussion about multiplication, guys. So, please, if you're new here, look at all my videos para sure talaga na top-notcher ka. Or kung hindi, passer ka. Then, we're not looking for 10x. We're just looking for x. So, i-divide natin siya kasi 10 divided by 10, 1x. 1. 1x is just x because 1 times x is x. Then, 105. And that's it. Makakakain siya ng 35 hot dogs in 105 minutes. Given that same pace lang po ang pagkain niya. Okay? Ang pagkakakain niya. Okay. So, usually, example sa mga proportion, ganun lang po ka-basic. Pero, may medyo higher level of question, which needs also higher level of analysis. Pero, the same lang pala ang way sa pagkasolve. May mga ganyan. Like this example. I would like also to thank now Khan Academy for the questions because I've searched for examples kasi pag maggawa ako, okay lang naman. Pero, I must be sure, no? So, I've searched for Khan Academy and these are the questions there. So, thank you, Khan Academy. A magic carpet is made with 3 colors of yarn. Imagine niyo. So, how one of the ways in solving problems also is drawing, if you can draw, imagining the situation, if you can imagine, ganyan. The ratio of each color sa carpet daw, 8 parts of gold yarn, 4 parts bronze, 3 parts silver. Ah, so different, 3 color ang magic carpet na sinakyan ni, example, sinakyan ni, sino bang sumakay doon? Si Tom and Jerry? Hindi ko na alam, nakalimutan ko. Ay, si Jasmine. The magic carpet is made with total of 150 meters of yarn. How much silver yarn is in the magic carpet? Hala, kanina, parang mga 2 numbers lang yun ang nandun. Kung si Sir Leo maka-clean ng 1 house in 2 days, ilang houses kung 4 days? Parang maganyan lang makwasyon. Ngayon, bakit 3 na? Mga bakit parts-parts na? 8 parts of gold, 4 parts of bronze, 3 parts of silver. Paano yan? Okay. If this is the case, guys, if this is this, if the question is similar to this, so, parts part to whole. Ganito guys ha, ang paggawa natin. Equals part to whole. Okay. So, okay lang to na proportion kasi part naman si top number, mga whole si bottom number. Ano ibig sabihin ng part? Ano ibig sabihin ng whole? Okay. Now, look at the question. Na-imagine nyo na no, si carpet, may 3 colors ng yarn. Siyempre, napakamaraming part si gold. Second si bronze, third lang si silver. Then, 150 meters daw lahat ng yarn. The question is, ilang metro si silver? Oh, part at whole, part at whole. Okay, ano ang inas na color? Silver. Ilang part si silver? 3 lang. So, ilagay natin dito si silver, 3 parts. So, whole. So, ha? So, since 3 parts si silver, at sa whole, ilang whole parts lahat? If we're talking about the whole part. So, may 8 parts gold, plus 4 parts bronze, 12, plus 3 parts silver. 15 lahat, sir. Yes, ilagay mo yan sa bottom number. Then, we're talking about yarn, how many meters, ilang parts si silver? Ilang metro si silver daw? Yan ang hindi natin alam, sir. Ang part is silver. Yes, if that's the case, dahil hindi natin alam, X yan. Si whole, alam natin, ilang ang kabuuhan lahat ng yarn na nagamit sa carpet. Sir, given siya 150. 150 ilagay. Part sa top number, whole sa bottom number, and you have that. Ganyan lang ka-basic. So, ano na? 15 times X, like what I said, kung saan si X lang, yun na muna pag i-first nyo multiply para hindi kayo ma-misled. X, 15X, 3 times 150, 450. Tapos, since we're looking for X, divide natin siya, then X is 30. Therefore, sir, ang silver yarn ay 30 meters. Okay, since we're just asked for the silver yarn, stop there. May answer ka na dapat, 30 meters. Diba? Easy lang ang ratio and proportion. Ang mga examples natin, the 3 examples earlier were easier than this. Pero, the idea is just the same. Diba? Very basic lang. Again, if you will be struck with this type of question, then isipin nyo parang pwedeng part whole. Sige daw, itry ko. Tapos na-answer mo. Tapos meron pa sa choices. Diba? Swerte mo na na nag-review ka, like, subscribe, and hit the notification bell. Diba? Share din sa other friends, guys. And this is your assignment. Number one, I'll read. If Arnold can type 600 pages for 21 days, for two, how many days daw kung 230 pages? Oh, easy lang. Easy lang ang pag-represent. Number two is like example number three kanina. Same pa rin na situation pero 10 parts of gold, 7 parts of bronze, 3 parts of silver. From, I've said the source. Pero wag mo na i-search si source, answer muna. Tapos, 150 meters. Now, the question is, how much gold and bronze? Kanina, silver kasi ang tanong. Okay? And that's just it. I hope you answer from the heart, step by step, and comment in the chat box, please. Okay? Again, congratulations. First, for studying the exam, for reviewing for the exam, and of course, the next part of that is passing the exam. If you're new here, like, subscribe, hit the notification bell for updates, and share with other friends, please. Thank you. Bye.